Dr. Claytor here, sharing the background of how neuromodulators work, and Julie, who is our PA awesome expert injector, is going to come in and give us some background about how some of the new neuromodulators are different. But I'm going to give everybody a little bit of background. Here is a nerve, and here is the muscle. The nerves work by releasing something called acetylcholine. Those are neurotransmitters, and they live in little vesicles or pockets within the nerve. They must be released from the nerve and come across this transition to the muscle for the muscle to contract. So they adhere to these little receptors. For the vesicle to bind to the wall of the nerve and release, it must interact with a protein called SNAP25. The whole basis of how neuromodulators work, the whole basis of how Botox works, is that it blocks SNAP25. When it blocks SNAP25, the vesicle cannot bind to the edge of the nerve and it cannot be released. That's it. It's that simple. That is how Botox work. That is how neuromodulators work. The exciting thing that Julie is going to share with us is how the newest modulator is different from the old school. So go ahead, Julie, tell us the big difference.
Yes, so the new product is called DAXXIFY, which is from Revance Aesthetics, and it's daxibotulinum toxin A. But it's combined with something called RTP-004, which is a stabilizing excipient peptide, which makes it last longer. All of the neurotoxins out right now last about 3 to 4 months. The DAXXIFY will last about 6 to 9 months.
That's incredible. Mm-hmm. My understanding is that this botulinum toxin has a negative charge on it, and that the excipient peptide, this Romeo Tango Papa 004, what's different about it is it changes the electrical charge on the outside mm-hmm. of the product. How does that have it last longer and be more productive?
Yeah, so the super positively charged RTP-004, that peptide, when attached to the daxibotulinum toxin A, it makes the whole thing positively charged, which is attracted, of course, to a negative charge, and it allows it to hang on to that neuronal surface, the nerve surface, longer, which in theory will allow that product to be internalized more, which will make it last longer.
So where exactly on this diagram is the DAXXIFY impacting this communication process?
So it's going to attach to the SNAP25 receptor.
Right here.
Yes. And not allow it to communicate.
And why is it going to stay there longer?
Because of the positive charge. It's going to be attracted longer.
So this RTP-004, mm-hmm. what is different about that compared to, let's say, a Botox product?
Yes, so the Botox product has human serum albumin, which doesn't have that charge, so it's not going to last as long. The DAXXIFY is actually made without the HSA, that human serum albumin, and just the RTP-004.
So if something's a human serum albumin, does it need to be refrigerated when it is shipped?
Yes, so that's a nice thing about the DAXXIFY as well. It can sit out without being reconstituted for up to 3 years. So you're going to save on packaging, no dry ice, nothing like that. And then once it's reconstituted, it can last up to 72 hours refrigerated. So if you have a patient on Friday, technically you can still use it on Monday.
So for the consumers, what patients don't really realize is that every single time we order a new shipment of a neuromodulator, it comes in this enormous box with dry ice in there and this huge thing of styrofoam. And I can only imagine how expensive it is in shipping, mm-hmm. as well as the styrofoam, the impact on, as we look at our greater impact of what it is that we're doing on our environment. This product, the DAXXIFY, does not need to be shipped in a cold pack.
Yes, correct.
And that's because it does not have the human serum albumin. Mm-hmm. And in place of that, it has this excipient peptide, which is called
RTP-004.
Of course, the pilot in me would call it the Romeo Tango Papa 004, but RTP is easier to remember. So one of the other things that's unique about what Revance is doing is where their products are made. Mm-hmm. So without talking about where the other companies make their products, Where does Revance make its product?
Yeah, so DAXXIFY is entirely made within the U.S. It's the only neurotoxin out there that is made, again, entirely in the United States.
Wow, that's impressive. Mm-hmm. That's really impressive today.